Hi, I'm Aina. I hope you can lend me your ears for a couple of minutes today. Do you guys aware about autism? Autism is a developmental disorder characterized by difficulties with social interactions and communications and by restricted and repetitive behavior. It is a condition that affects the brain and makes the communicating and interacting with other people more difficult. This makes it hard for them to express themselves, either with words or through gestures, facial expressions, and also touch. People with autism might also have problems with learning. Their skills might develop unevenly. For example, they could have trouble communicating with, but be unusually good at art, music, math, or memory. Because of this, they might do especially well on tests of analysis or problem solving. Some studies have been conducted in the 1960s and 1970s in Europe and the United States, where it is estimated that in the range of 2 to 4 cases per 10,000 children were reported as the first case. This led to the impression that autism was a rare childhood disorder. However, by 2002, estimates of the prevalence of the autism in the United States were in the range of 6 to 7 per 1,000 children, which is it is more than 30-fold increases from the first studies of autism prevalence. This number began to increase hugely during the decades of 20th century until today. However, the cause of autism is still unknown, but genetics, different in brain anatomy, and toxic substances in the environment are thought to contribute to children developing the condition. Today, I'm going to share with you guys the topic that have been in surface for so long between the scientists, analysts, and also researchers. That is, are there any relation between childhood immunization and autism? Childhood immunization is the process which an individual's immune system becomes fortified, or in simple words, is protected against an immunogen. What is immunogen? An immunogen is an antigen or any substance that may be specifically bound by components of the immune system. The term antigen arises from its ability to induce generation of antibodies, or it can simply be defined as a substance that produces an immune response. So there are lots of methods of immunization, which includes intraocular, or we call it eye drop, nasal instillation method, intramolecular injection method, and etc. Nevertheless, most commonly method is vaccination. Now, we're going to look at the vaccine part. Vaccine is a biological preparation that provides active acquired immunity to a particular infectious disease. There are these issues arise where parents refuse to vaccinate their children. The best belief that natural immunity is better. Yes, according to some research, it is true. However, there will be a serious risk, such as natural chickenpox, that can lead to pneumonia. As we all know that everything has its pros and cons, so does vaccine itself. Even the vaccine is more preferable compared to natural immunity, it also can give a several impact, both minor and major aspects. From a minor side, it can prescribe a low-grade fever, fuzziness and soreness at the injection site. While on the major site, it can show several allergic reactions and also neurological side effects. There's two controversies regarding the vaccine which people thought it can cause autism. The first one is MMR vaccine controversies, which is measles, mumps and rubella. It recorded rapid increases in the number of kids diagnosed with the condition. However, until 1998, none found any evidence that the vaccine caused autism. And the second one is Temercel controversy. Temercel controversy started with the fact that vaccine contained mercury, which is it is very harmful to the brain and also the kidney at high levels. However, until 2002, there was no evidence that a small amount used in the medicine can cause harm, where more specifically can cause autism. So that's all from me. So note that epidemic autism spectrum disorder has increased dramatically until today. Even so, studies have shown that there is no link between receiving vaccine and developing ASD, which also stands for Autism Spectrum Disorder. It has been proved by a research of 2013 CDC study showing that vaccine do not cause ASD. Thank you and bye.